Okay, so here we have Unit 4. We're going to begin this unit with a discussion of the types of chemical reactions. Now, for this section of Unit 4, we're only going to deal with two objectives. The first is we're going to look at how you know a chemical reaction has taken place, and then we're going to categorize chemical reactions according to five main types. Yeah. So as we go through this PowerPoint, we're going to deal first with the signs of a chemical reaction, and then we'll go into the types of chemical reactions that we're going to talk about. Now remember from Unit 3, a chemical reaction is just an equation that represents a chemical change, and that means where we have the starting material or the reactants that are going to be changed into products through some type of alteration of their chemical composition. Now, there are technically five main types of main signs of a chemical reaction. The first is color change. Now, this is not the color change where you take Kool-Aid, you add some ice, and as it dilutes down, it turns a lighter color. It's something like this where you had two colorless solutions that change color into something completely different. It's not mixing yellow and blue to make green. It is something that does not necessarily make sense. And so here we had you can see a colorless and a pink, and they turned to blue and green. And it's an oscillating reaction, so they actually go back and forth for a while. But the point is, this is a spontaneous color change that does not have to do with something that is either being diluted or mixing. The second is a gas evolving, or usually what you're going to see like in the lab is bubbling. And you guys have two sets of labs where you get to observe that bubbling happening. Now, just a little further than I meant to go, he's going to take powder, mix it into a solution, and as a reaction happens, because he's adding so much powder here, he gets a lot of bubbling. And you can actually see with the size of the balloon that there's a lot of gas that's being evolved. This is again part of the chemical reaction. It's not like when you shake a soda and the dissolved gas just comes out of the liquid. It is a reaction where a gas is a product. Now the third, and probably the most interesting, is a precipitation. This is an instantaneous thing usually, where you have two soluble aqueous solutes, they get mixed together, and they form an insoluble product. So here you have two colorless and clear solutions that are going to, as soon as they mix, form a insoluble precipitate. And what it looks like for us really is just cloudy. So in lab, you're going to see usually a cloudy, the substance turns cloudy, and then eventually it will settle to the bottom of the test tube or well plate. Fourth type is heat change. You can usually see these in either hand warmers or ice packs. When you buy them, they have a little bit of water in them, and then there's an inflated packet in the middle. And what happens is if you squeeze hard and break this packet, the powder will come out and mix with the water. As soon as that happens, you end up getting a heat change. Now, for an ice pack, it makes it very cold. You can use it for an injury. If it is a heat pack, it's going to be a salt that's going to cause a rise in temperature. And then finally, you could also see a pH change. And we're going to talk about those with acid-base reactions in a little bit. The idea is here you have an acidic solution mixing with a basic solution, and you end up getting a different pH, usually neutral if you do it just right, but we'll see how it goes. Now, once you know what type of chemical once you know you have a chemical reaction that has taken place, you can then look to see what type of chemical reaction you have. Now, there's five main types, and we're going to go through these one at a time. Synthesis is where you synthesize or make something. These are also called combination reactions sometimes, and it's because it's where you have two reactants mixing together to make a single product. So here we have A plus B goes to C, two on the reactant side, one on the product side. This is something like sodium mixing with chlorine gas to produce sodium chloride. Now, again, guys, think back to Unit 2 and 3 where we're talking about chemical composition. Here we have a metal that is highly reactive, will essentially react with the water in the atmosphere to throw off sparks, catch fire, almost explode, but not quite. Then you have a chlorine gas, which is technically, it's green in color, but it's technically toxic. You mix these two things together, the chemical composition of sodium chloride is completely different. It's neither a metal or a reactive substance, nor is it poisonous. It is a benign, somewhat tasty compound that you use at most meals, whether you intend to or not. And so the chemical composition of the reactants is changed in a chemical reaction. So anyway, this is a synthesis reaction. Decomposition is almost exactly the opposite of synthesis. Here you have a single reactant that is going to break apart or decompose to form two reactants. So here we have A goes to B plus C. The most common are things like chlorate compounds or carbonate compounds that will break apart to form a new compound and some kind of gas. There it goes. Okay. The third type of chemical reaction is combustion. Here you have a reactant that is going to burn in the presence of oxygen to form CO2 gas and water vapor. Now, these three components of a chemical reaction are essentially the same for a combustion. This X is the only thing that's different. So, for example, here we have propane that's reacting with oxygen to make CO2 and water. But it doesn't matter. As long as this compound is burned in the presence of oxygen, you should form carbon dioxide and water. That is how you know it is a combustion reaction. It doesn't really matter for us if we're burning a candle, if we're burning gas in your gas tank. It just will look like combustion if you react with oxygen to make these two products. A single replacement reaction is one where you have an element reacting with a compound, and what will happen is the element that is being replaced, or the element that is reacting will replace a similar element in the compound. So A plus BC goes to AC plus B. So here A and B are both metals and they just switch places, or cations if you want to think of it that way. So for example, we could have something like copper reacting with silver nitrate to make copper nitrate and silver. And you can kind of see copper comes over here, kicks this silver out, and then decides to replace take its place. Silver is then going to be left alone as a metal, and copper is going to be paired with the nitrate. Same thing down here. Magnesium reacts with water to make magnesium hydroxide and H2. Remember, when we're balancing equations, we can kind of think of water as H bonded to an OH. So this magnesium comes out and kicks off the hydrogen, which is acting as a cation for our purpose at the moment, to make hydrogen come out, magnesium is now going to be able to pair with hydroxide. Double replacement reactions are when you have two compounds that will essentially have two. Two elements that switch place. There's a couple of ways to think about this. Usually there's people that will draw arrows like this, so A and C switch partners. You can also think about it in terms of outer and inner. So if I were going to do it that way, you kind of think about A going with D because these are the two outer. B is going to go with C because they're the two inner elements. And so you have, actually, this is a typo right here. It should be BC. Or no, CB is right. We're good. So you have the two outer and the two inner. Two examples of this are something like silver nitrate reacting with sodium chloride to make silver now goes with chlorine to make silver chloride and sodium nitrate. Remember, the cations always come first. For a similar type of reaction, we have hydrochloric acid reacting with sodium hydroxide. H is going to go with OH because these are the two outers, and sodium is going to go with chlorine because those are the two inners. And so you make your compounds. Now, guys, here the compounds look very similar, but make sure, remember over here, magnesium is a, when it forms an ion is 2 plus, hydroxide is 1 minus. Make sure you are considering the chemical composition of each compound, okay? Write the formulas before you balance. An example of a double replacement reaction in terms of something that is still pretty wildly used today, or widely, is to use a reaction between silver nitrate and either HCl or sodium chloride to make a mirror. They actually sell these kits everywhere. Flynn sells them as ornament kits, and you can usually buy them as mirror plating kits as well. And so you kind of take these two reagents and you mix them together, and as they stir, you first see a color change where it turns kind of black, and then in a few seconds it's going to turn silver to indicate that it is forming this precipitant and it is going to make a reflective surface. This is actually how they've done it for years. I think there's a couple of new techniques out there that are a little bit more, well, not only cheap, but also they last a little bit longer. If you've ever seen an old mirror, they turn kind of blackish gray after a while. And so you can kind of see the reflective surface is forming. And so that's kind of a double replacement reaction. That is it for this unit, and we will continue in other videos.